Projection means it's like an idea of a projection is like a shadow cast by an object. Okay. For example, if you are going to have a ball. Okay. So the shadow of that ball, you call it to be projection. Okay. Suppose if this is red color, right? So the shadow of that, if it is going to be the shadow of this upper ball, you call it to be the projection. Okay. So I'm going to take, suppose for example, projection of a sphere. If I'm going to keep a sphere on a plane, the shadow of that will be a stump. Yes? Yes, Deepika, I'm going to take a sphere or a ball. Okay. You take it as a ball itself. Imagine a ball. Okay. And you are going to keep it on a plane surface. Okay. So some rays or something is coming means the rays of that, that is the projection, will be a circle. Okay. So a vector can be projected onto another vector. Okay. So it's like, for example, I will take one more. For example, see, I've already told that your vector will be having both magnitude and direction. Okay. So for here, what I will do here is projection of vector. Okay. I'm going to take a vector, say AB vector. I'm going to do this projection on the axis L. Okay. It is nothing but the number equal to the value of the segment on the given axis L. Okay. For example, you will be using the formula as the vector projection. Okay. You are going to take two vectors. Okay. A vector is the vector projection A vector. This is the sphere you just assume. You are going to make it on B vector. Okay. It's nothing but the unit vector of B. Okay. It's the unit vector of B. Okay. It will be by a scalar projection. That means it will follow the direction only. Okay. Wherever direction you are keeping, that way. Okay. Scalar projection. We use the formula to be, okay, projection of your, this is the symbol or the thing we will be using, okay. Projection of A vector over B vector is A dot B over absolute value of your B vector squared, okay, is dot B vector. You understand? Yes, Deepika? Okay.
Yeah.
So this is the formula. We use it for finding the projection of one vector over the other. Okay, suppose they are saying that there is a scalar projection. Okay, so a scalar projection means we are mainly concentrating nothing but the magnitude, that is the direction of the vector projection, right? So magnitude means scalar projection of your A vector on your B vector, okay, will be nothing but your projection of your, okay. This is A vector, I'm going to apply it on the B vector. So absolute value of A vector dot B vector divided by absolute value of B vector. Okay, you got it? Fine, Deepika?
Yeah.
See, for example, I will take a problem. If I'm going to have, find the projection of, okay, find the projection of vectors, okay, projection of vector, fine, A vector equals to 1 comma 2 on the vector, B vector equal to, okay, I'm taking my own value, okay, so B vector 3 comma 4, okay, fine. So how we have to calculate this one? First we have to see original formula is what, your projection of your, we have to calculate, okay, your A vector over B vector, okay, magnitude, right? So that is nothing but A vector dot B vector divided by your absolute value of your B vector. So for all these things, first I need what is A dot B. Yes, Deepika? Fine. So what I'm going to do is, first I'm going to find, so what is my A vector? Your A vector is, I've taken it as 1 comma 2. Okay. Your B vector is nothing but 3 comma 4. Okay, let me find the dot product for this. Okay, so first I will find A dot B. So what will be my A dot B? So 1.3 plus it is 2.4. So it is 3 plus 8, which is 11. Got it? Next one. I need to find, according to the formula, A dot B divided by absolute value of B vector I need. Okay. So I'm calculating that also. Okay. So what is your B vector? The absolute value of B vector is 3 square plus 4 square. Okay, Deepika. So that would be square root of 9 plus 16. So that would be square root of 25. Correct. So that would be 25, 5. Okay. Now we are going to calculate the vector projection. Got it? So what is a vector projection? So projection of your A vector over your B vector. So what is that? It is A dot B, okay, divided by absolute value of your B vector, the whole square, times B vector. Okay, Deepika? So let me apply the formula. A dot B is nothing but 11. Okay. B vector square is 25. Okay. Then this one is nothing but multiplied by your B vector. So B vector is 5. Okay, Deepika. So if I cancel this, this will become 5. So it is 11 upon 5.
Yeah.
You got it? Yes, Deepika. Now, this is for only 2 vectors. Okay. If I'm going to give it for 3 vectors, okay, that also I will show you. Is 3 vectors there for you? Try the projection. Only 2 vectors, right? Okay, fine. 3 you have, right? Okay, okay. So then I will take 1, 4, 0 I will have. Okay. Then projection of A vector over B. What number I can take? Okay, 4, 2, 4. See, previous problem, I have left the answer in fractions. Okay. If your teacher is specifying, just change it into decimals. Okay. Now, so A, B I have taken. So you need to find the projection of the vector, that is A vector over B vector. Okay. The same formula. So for that, we need to find what is A dot B first. Okay. So that's nothing but 1.4. First vector, component with the first component. Second component with the second component. Third with the third. Okay. So 4 plus 8 plus 0. So 12. Okay, now I'm going to calculate the magnitude of your B vector. So what is that? The square root of your 4 square plus 2 square plus 4 square. Okay, let me calculate this. So that is 16 plus 4 plus 16. 36. So square root of your 36 will be 6. Okay, got it to pick up? So I'm going to calculate the projection of your the A vector over B vector. So that would be nothing but A vector dot B vector, okay, divided by absolute value of your B vector, the whole square, dot your B vector, okay. Let me calculate this. A dot B, A dot B will be 12, okay, and this would be 36, right, whole square multiplied by, you should have, your B vector is 4, 2, 4. This is the difference between the two orthogonal, two vectors and 3 vectors, okay? So, components of 3 means this will be the difference. Now, what I will do, I'm going to make it, I'm going to cancel this, okay? So, if I'm going to have it for this one, first coordinate but first, okay? So, if I cancel this, 4 tables, right? 4 nines are 36. Am I right? Yeah. Then, this I can have it as 4 upon 3. Okay, Deepika? So, first coordinate will be 4 upon 3. Same 12 upon 36, you have to take it for this one also. If I cancel once again. 2 is there. Cancel it. So, it will be 2 upon 3. Okay? Fine, Deepika? Next one. Again, 12 upon 36 is common for this 4 also. This 4 also. So, same thing. Let me cancel it. This will be again 4 upon 3. Okay? The last one. We need to find, I'm writing it here on the side. We need to find the scalar projection. That is projection of your A vector over B vector. That is the magnitude we are finding. Okay. So scalar projection is otherwise known as the magnitude. Okay. So this is the formula. So in that case, A dot B is nothing but 12, okay, divided by your absolute value of your B. So that is nothing but your 6. Just, okay. Yes, Deepika, got it? So shall we start doing some problems? Or shall I give you one or two problems you'll try?
No.
Okay. Just a second. I hope this one will happen.